So let's start. This is 8th lecture on digital electronics, and in today's class we shall discuss following topics. We shall talk about counters. Basically our focus will be on binary counters, and we will discuss about two different kind of counters, the asynchronous one and synchronous. This asynchronous counter is also called a ripple counter. And then if time permits, we shall start our discussion on transistors in general and at bipolar junction transistor in particular. Okay. So before we start our discussion on counter, let me very quickly revise the concept of T flip flop. For the T flip flop, the symbol is like this. It is one input flip-flop with input is T and two outputs are Q and Q bar, which are complement to each other. And apart from this T input, we have another input here, that is the clock input. Okay. And basically this T flip flop can be very easily realized from a JK flip flop if we tie both J and K inputs together. Okay. That means if I have one JK flip flop, K, the two outputs Q and Q complement, if I tie these two inputs together, then basically it becomes a T flip flop. Gate level implementation of this JK flip flop has already been discussed in the previous class. Okay. And therefore, the characteristics table for this T flip flop is as follow. If I take first column as a Q input, the previous state output QT, and then the T input here, and here the output after the clock pulse, next state output, that is also called QT plus 1. Then for the inputs combination 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1, you know from the characteristics of a JK flip flop, if both inputs are 0, okay, then after the clock appears, the output is what? Why 0? Because of the previous state was 0. Okay. If the input was 0, I mean both J and K were 0, then QT plus 1 is simply QT. Okay. So, for when J and K are 0 and the previous output was 0, so after the receiving a clock pulse, the next state output QT plus 1 become 0. Okay. But if the T is 1 means the J and K both are at 1. So in this case, the flip flop will toggle to the complement state. That means if it is in set state, it will go into reset state. If it was earlier in set state, reset state, then it will go into the set state. Okay. That means if the T input is 1 and previous state is QT, 0, then after receiving the clock pulse, it becomes 1. It will toggle to the next state. Okay. So here it becomes 1. Again, if the T input is 0, the QT plus 1, the next state will be the equal to the previous state, and previous state is output 1. So here we will have 1, and this is again this will toggle, the flip flop will toggle if the T is 1 and the previous output is 1, so it will toggle from 1 to 0. Okay. So because of this reason, that when the T input is 1, if the T input is 1 and a flip flop, when the flip flop receives a clock pulse, it shifts to the next is, I mean, complementary state. That means it toggles. Okay, that's why it is called toggle flip-flop or T flip-flop. Okay, if T is 1, then its next state QT plus 1 is actually the complement of QT. Okay, it always toggle when it receives a clock. Okay, that's why it is called toggle flip-flop or T flip-flop. Okay. And if I have to write the characteristics equation for this T flip-flop, then I can use a K-map, two variable K-map in fact, Q and T is 0, 1, 0, 1. I can write the mean terms 1 here and another 1 at this position. Okay, then simply our QT plus 1, the next state output becomes Q bar T plus QT bar. Okay, it is Q bar T plus QT bar. Okay, even you examine this characteristics table, what you see that this is identical to that of an XOR gate. I told you that XOR gate compares to inputs. If both inputs are same, the output remains 0. So, you see both are same, output 0. If these are different, output is 1. That is why we get here the characteristics equation is in this form. Okay, because for an XOR gate, if the two inputs are x and y, so output becomes y equal to x y bar plus x bar y. Okay, because of this kind of truth table for that XOR gate. Okay, so therefore, you see here even our characteristics equation for the T flip-flop becomes like this. Okay, and what is the implication of this complement at the receiving of each clock pulse? Let me explain this with the help of a timing diagram. Okay. Let us say that we have this clock input like this, for example, let us say that this frequency for this square wave is 1 kilohertz, okay, and our flip flop here is a positive triggering flip flop. That means when the clock pulse field move from 0 to 1, the flip flop will toggle to the next state if T is 1. Okay. So, the clock pulse, this flip flop, since it is a positive edge triggered flip flop, it will trigger when this situation will arise, when the clock pulse change its states from 1 to 0 to 1. This is clock pulse. Okay. So, one triggering will take place here, another triggering will take place here, when again this clock pulse changes from 0 to 1, then it will be here and at this position it is here. Okay. And now let us say that the Q for this given flip flop, the T is always 1, it is a 1 signal is permanently given to this T flip flop. Okay, and this clock pulse is applied here to this clock pulse input, and the Q was originally 0. When no clock pulse was applied, Q was 0. Okay, so now let us find out what will be, how this Q will change after, once this input clock pulse is applied to this flip flop. Okay, I mean, what will be the response of this flip flop for this given clock pulse wave, okay, for this given clock wave, okay. So, you see that we assume here that initially it was at 0 state, so here it was at 0 state, but since this is a positively edge triggered flip flop, so when this flip flop is changing states from 0 to 1, the flip fluff will complement. That means if initially it was 0, it will be complemented to 1. Okay, it changes its states from 0 to 1. So, the flip flop will change its state from 0 to 1. This was 0 state. Let us say that this is our 1 state. Okay, and it will remain in 1 state until the next clock pulse arises, until the positive edge of the next clock pulse arises. Okay. So, since this is negative edge from 1 to 0, this will not be detected by the flip flop. The flip flop will respond to again this triggering from 0 to 1. So, at the moment when this 0 to 1 transition will take place, you see, since the output is at 1 state, the flip flop will toggle to the 0 state. Okay. So, the Q becomes here 0. Okay. And it will remain 0 as long as it gets the next triggering here. Here it will become 1 and then it will again become 0. Getting this point? This timing diagram is drawn considering the T is permanently connected to logic 1. Okay. T input is always high. Is it clear? So, what you see here, that even you can see that if the wave, if the frequency for this input signal is 1 kilohertz, what will happen to this signal? Frequency changes, time period doubles, so frequency will become 1 half, it is 500 hertz only. Okay. Is it clear? So, this how actually you draw the timing diagram for a given sequential circuit. Okay. Is it clear? Now, we can use this concept to analyze a counter circuit. Okay. You can keep this in your mind. It will be useful when we discuss the counter circuit. So, binary counter is a circuit which counts the occurrence of the number of the input clocks. Okay. If there are 4 clocks appeared, then basically the binary output will be 1, 0, 0, okay, 0, 1, 0, 0. Okay. If it is a 4-bit binary counter. So, you see here, this, if it is a binary counter, then there will be input signal where some sort of control signal will appear. It may be the same clock signal which we have, which I have shown you earlier. Okay. So, this is let us say that clock input and the binary output will be, if we consider a 3-bit binary counter, then basically there will be 3 output line. Okay. This one let us say is least significant bit and this one is most significant bit. Okay. So, this counter will simply counts how many clocks has appeared at the input. Okay. For example, initially this binary counter will remain in 0, 0, 0 state. Okay. Once the clock is received, the first clock, the output here becomes 0, 0, 1. Okay. When the second clock appears, then output changes to 0, 1, 0. When the third clock appears, it becomes 0, 1, 1 and so on. Okay. So, this is the binary counter. Okay. And here the counter which I have shown you is basically called down up counter, it's called up counter. Okay, because it starts from 0 0 0 and goes to the higher level, from 0 0 0 to 0 0 1 0 1 0, okay, 0 1 1 and so on. Similarly, I can have a down counter. This was actually up counter, which counts from 0 to 7, okay, a down counter will count from 7 to 0, okay, if it is a 3 bit binary counter, okay. And the counter circuit can be classified as asynchronous or synchronous. You see here that the counter circuits will basically be designed using the flip-flop, okay. And if all flip-flops are not given the same clock pulse, then it will be called an asynchronous counter or ripple counter, okay. For example, let us say that if I have 3 flip-flops in our counter circuit, okay. And I am applying clock to only this flip-flop, external clock. Not all not all flip-flops are being triggered by the same clock, okay. Then it is called the asynchronous counter. In fact, here it is because the synchronization is not important, not necessary, okay. So this is asynchronous counter or ripple counter, because output propagates, signal propagates in a ripple fashion, in a ripple manner, okay. I mean at a particular point the signal may change quickly and finally it will settle to the steady state value or final value, okay. Getting my point? I mean you have to wait for some time before getting the actual output, because the state of flip flop may change in between, okay. So, the point is at this moment I would like to say here that in asynchronous counter the synchronization of the flip flop is not important, okay. The clock pulse will be given to, may be given to only one flip flop at a time, okay. But in this case, in case of synchronous counter, all flip flops will be clocked or triggered simultaneously, okay. We have to use the same clock pulse to trigger all flip-flops. For example, in this case, if here I have a clock input and the clock input for this flip-flop, clock input for this flip-flop, all clock inputs should be connected and they will be supplied same clock, okay, clock wave or clock pulse. So this is synchronous type of counter, whereas in asynchronous counter, synchronization is actually not important, okay. And please note here that I am not going to tell you how to design a counter circuit or a sequential circuit. What I am going to show you that how a flip flop is useful for a counter design, okay, or what is the role of flip flop in a counter circuit, okay. So one by one I will take, first I will take the asynchronous counter and then we shall also discuss about this synchronous counter circuit, okay. So first of all we will take this asynchronous counter. So before going to the circuit for the asynchronous counter, okay, let me give you the counting sequence. Counting sequence for a up counter, if it is a 3 bit counter, then it will be like this. The first count will be 000, okay. Then the next count will be, next state will be 001, then the next state is 010. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and finally 1, 1, 1, okay. We are going to talk about 3 bit counter. You can extend the concept to any number, 4 bit, 5 bit, 6 bit, 7 bit, whatever you want, okay. The same concept can be applied to even 4 bit, 5 bit or 6 bit, 7 bit counter, whatever you want. Okay, so please look at the sequence. This refers decimal 0, this 1, 2, 3. I mean, if 3 clock pulse occur, then the output will of the binary counter will be this. This 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay. So, we have total 8 sequences. And if you examine these sequences, you will find some interesting things which are actually utilized for the counter circuit design. Okay. Just examine this column, which is for the LSBs, lower significant bit. Okay. What you see here? That this LSB always gets complemented. Okay. That means it is always toggling from 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 1. Okay. It is always changing its state from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. Okay. Now, examine this second column. What you find here? You can observe that when the LSB is changing from 1 to 0, only at that moment the next significant bit is getting changed. Okay. For example, you see here that first time the LSB changing from 1 to 0 here. Okay. Is it clear? And you can notice here that at the same moment, the next significant bit changes from 0 to 1. If the LSB is changing from 0 to 1, there will be no change to the next significant bit. Okay. Then you can here again notice the same thing. The LSB is changing here from 1 to 0, and you can notice that the next significant bit is also changing from 1 to 0. Okay. Then again here LSB is changing from 1 to 0 and next significant bit changing from 0 to 1. Okay. So, what you notice here? That when the least significant bit changes, is changing from 1 to 0, only at that moment or only then the next significant bit is changing its state. Okay. If it is in 0 state, it is changing to 1 state. For when in was in 1 state, it is changing to 0 state. Is it clear or not? And this is also true for the most significant bit. Okay. Also notice here, the most significant bit is changing only when the least significant bit is changing from 1 to 0. Is it or not? See here that there is no change, 0, 0, 0 to 1, no change here, 1 to 1, no change here, but when it is changing from 1 to 0, then only the most significant bit is changing from 0 to 1. Okay. And after this, there is no change, there is no 1 to 0 change, so no change in the most significant bit. Okay. Getting this point? So, summary is, a particular bit is changing its state when the lower significant bit is changing from 1 to 0. Okay. Actually, this property of this counting sequence is utilized to design an asynchronous counter. Okay. Let's see how. I am giving the circuit and I will show you how this property is utilized for designing that circuit. Okay. So, let me give a circuit of a 3-bit asynchronous counter implemented using a JK flip-flop. Basically, it is used as a T flip-flop. Please note here that the number of flip-flop will depends upon the number of bit. Okay. That means, if you want to design a 3-bit counter, you need 3 flip-flop. Okay. And in that case, there will be total 8 states. You can count from 0 to 7. Okay. And your counter is said to be modulo 8 counter. Okay. Modulus 8 counter. Similarly, for 4 bit, there will be total 16 sequences. So it is called modulo 16 counter, and you need 4 flip flop. Okay. So since we are going to design a 3 bit counter here using JK flip flop, so we need 3 flip flops, and those 3 flip flops are drawn here. Okay. So this is a JK flip flop with J input here, K input, and the output Q here with a, let us say that we are using a negative clock here. Then JK, negative clock, Q, JK, Q, and the clock is negative. Okay, this is our least significant bit, A0, A1, and here I will have A2. Okay, this was A0, A1, and A2. Okay. Now you see that in the first column we always need a change. Whenever a clock occurs, there should be a change. Okay. So what should I do? If I put both J and K, if I connect these two J and K and give 1 here, okay, and then the count input, if I connect to this negative S triggered input, the count input is here, okay. Is this flip flop not going to realize this column? Since it is giving A0 as a output, okay. And once this, at the moment when this flip flop receives a input count, it will change its state, because both J and K are connected to 1 in toggle state. It is just like being used as a T flip flop. And you know that for a T flip flop, whenever you will give a suitable triggering to this flip flop, it will change its state. So let us say that initially it was in 0 state, so whenever it will receive a count input, it will change its state. Okay. So A0 is realized in this manner. Okay. And what do you mean by negative S triggering? Negative triggering means when the clock is changing from 1 to 0, okay, then only the flip flop will change its state, is it or not? Okay. And here what I need, here you have already noticed that when this output, A0 output, means output here, when it is changing from 1 to 0, okay, then only I want change in A1 or here. Okay. So what should I do to realize this? I mean, when A0 is changing from 1 to 0, then only I want a change in A1. Okay. I can connect this output to this clock, and I can again give this JK input to 1. Okay. Is it serving our purpose? Now you can see, when this A0 will change from 1 to 0, the A1 is going to change, because this is negative S triggered flip flop. That means when this clock pulse will change from 1 to 0, then only this A1 is going to change. Okay. So we have captured that thing, which is obvious, which is there in this table. Okay. And similarly, we can do the same thing for this A2 here. Because again you can see that when the A1 changes from 1 to 0, then only A2 changes. Okay. So I can again use this Q as a clock for this flip flop, and let me connect J and K to 1. Okay. So this is our counter, 3 bit counter, asynchronous counter, A2, A1, and A0. Okay. even you can extend it to 4-bit counter, 5-bit counter, whatever you want by using more number of flip-flops. Okay, you can follow this sequence. You can just take the output of a particular state and that can be given to the clock of the next state. Okay, and you can have a 4-bit counter, 5-bit counter and so on. Is it clear? Is it clear or not? So, you can see here that if initially this A2, A1 and 0, let us say that it was 0, 0, okay. So, at the moment when it receives the first clock, first count, what will happen? This flip flop will toggle from 0 state to 1 state, okay. So, this will toggle from 0 state to 1 state, but this will not toggle because the clock is not changing from 1 to 0. Although both inputs are 1, but this flip-flop will not respond to this change from 0 to 1. It will respond to change from 1 to 0 only. Okay. So, this will remain in 0 state, similarly this will remain in 0 state. Okay. And when the next clock pulse appear, now this will change from 1 to 0 because it will always toggle. Okay. And when this changing from 1 to 0, then only this state will change from 0 to 1. Okay. So, here it will change from 0 to 1 and no change for this flip flop. So, you will get the next sequence, that is 0 1 0 corresponds to 2. Okay. I can show the same operation using the timing diagram again. Okay. Let us say that the clock pulse is given by this pulse train. Symmetrical wave in fact, but I have not drawn it properly. Okay, this is our clock pulse and the clock pulse, the flip flops here are negative edge triggered. So, negative edge triggered means the flip flop will respond to this, this, this edge, this edge and this edge. Okay. Is it clear? Then I am going to draw the A0. The least significant bit. Okay. So, A0 is here. Initially you see that A0 was at 0 level. Okay. So, A0 is initially 0. Where it will, that A0 will change its state? When clock move from 1 to 0. So, at this moment the A0 will change from 0 to 1. Okay. So, here I have changed it from 0 to 1. This is our 1 state. Okay. And how long it will remain in this 1 state? Until this next transition of 1 to 0 occurs. So, it will come here up to this point, then it will go to 0 state, then again here it will go to 1 state, it will complement, okay. Then next time it will complement here and again it will complement here. Okay. Is it clear? So, this is A0. Okay. And what about A1? Let us say that initially the A1 is at 0 state. Okay. Initially the A1 is at 0 state. So, let me start here it from 0 level. Okay. So, when it is going to complement A1? At which moment it will complement? When this A0 will change from 1 to 0. Okay. So, it will be in 0 state as long as the previous bit, that means A0 is not changing from 1 to 0. It will complement here when A0 will change from 1 to 0. Okay. So, here it will complement. Then next time it will complement here. And what about the A2? When it will complement? When A1 changes from 1 to 0. It will complement at this moment only. Okay. So at this moment, basically A1, A2 becomes, A2 changes from 0 to 1. Here only. Okay. Like this. So you can see, you can look at the sequences. For the first clock pulse, here all are 0, 0 and 0, okay. Then here after the first edge triggering from 1 to 0, you will see that the A0 becomes 1, A1 is still 0, A2 is still 0, okay. Then after next clock pulse, A1 is, A0 is 0, A1 is 1 and A2 is 0. So we have got 0, 1, 0 sequence. Then after next clock pulse, what we have? A0, 1, A1 is also 1, A2 is 0. So we have 0, 1, 1, 3. So you see here, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3 and similarly you will get 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So, the operation of this asynchronous counter can also be explained using the timing diagram for all inputs A0, A1, A2 including the clock pulse, okay. Now, let me talk about synchronous counter. Okay. Now, I will say you to again examine the same counting sequences, counting states you can say 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, 1. Okay. This is our least significant bit, A1 and A2 the most significant bit. Okay. So from this counting sequence, you can also notice another important point. Okay, and what is that? The important point is, look here. Here, let us say that A0 is in one state, okay. So, what you see, when next clock pulse appear, A1 gets complemented from 0 to 1, okay. Similarly, the A0 is 1 here. So, what you see, in the after next clock pulse, the A1 complemented from 1 to 0, okay. Then you see here, again A0 is 1. Then A1 complemented from 0 to 1 state, okay. And again notice this point here, this sequence 1 0 0, look at the previous sequence, it was 0 1 1. So when the two lower significant bits were at 1 1, then only the higher significant bits gets complemented after the next cycle, okay. Getting this point? When the lower significant bit is at 1, the next significant bits gets complemented after the next clock pulse, okay. Is it clear? Or the bit at the third position will be complemented only when the both inputs, both, I mean the two lower significant bits are at one state, okay. And similarly, if we let us say are dealing with 4 bit counter, then the 4th bit will be complemented only when the all 3 lower significant bits are at 1, okay. For example, let us say that we had this 0, 1, 1, 1 sequence, okay. Then after getting the next clock pulse, I mean the next sequence is going to be 1, 0, 0. Is it clear? Why? Because one is complementing after each clock pulse the lower significant bit. Okay. This bit is complementing because the lower bit is 1. So, this is 1 to 0. This bit is complementing because again the both lower bits are, lower significant bits are 1. So, that is why this is complementing from 1 to 0. Okay. And this bit is complementing because the all lower significant bits are 1. Okay. If we had one more 0 here, then that 0 would have not been complemented here, because all lower significant bits are not 1 in this case. So, this should have been 0 here. Okay. Getting this point? A bit will complement at a when it receives a clock only when the other lower significant bits are at 1. Okay, getting this point? So, if we can utilize this property of this counting sequence to implement a synchronous counter. Okay, we can again use, if we are interested about a 4 bit counter, we can a 3 bit counter, we can use 3 flip flops. Okay, and can use a common clock to all flip flop because we are dealing with a synchronous counter. Okay, so let me take here 3 flip flops, JK flip flop in this case, again JK, Q and Q bar. JK, Q and Q bar. J input, K input, Q and Q bar. This Q is going to be our A0, this one is A1, this one is A2. Okay. All flip flops are complemented by single clock pulse. So, we have a single clock pulse for all 3 flip flops. This is our clock pulse. Okay. And apart from this clock pulse, we shall also have a counting enable in this case. Okay. A counting enable input. Will be connected here, JK flip flop, it will be tied together, or you say this is our counting enable. What I mean to say is, before applying the clock pulse to count the sequence, binary sequences, you need to enable this input. You have to connect a high input signal here. You have to connect a 1 here. That is basically called the count enable. Okay. And then the output of this state Q will be taken here, and the same count enable will be ANDed together here, and the output of this AND gate will be given to J and K flip flops. Okay. And then this output will again be taken here, and Q bar of this flip flop will be ANDed with this output. And this output will be given to both J and K. Okay. And this can propagate if you want to design a 4 bit counter or 5 bit counter like that. Otherwise, this will not be extended further. Okay. So, let me stop here. okay. So counting enable, once you give a counting enable signal, what will happen? This flip flop will receive 1 at both J and K input. It's just like a T flip flop. It will toggle after each and every clock pulse. Okay. So whenever it will receive a clock pulse, a proper triggered clock pulse, in that case this flip flop will toggle. It will move from 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, like that. Okay. But what about the next flip flop? What you see here, that the count enable is ANDed with this A0. Okay. That means when the A0 as well as this count enable, when both are 1, then only we are going to get 1 here, and that 1 is applied to JK input of this flip flop. Okay. So when here at this point we will have 1, then only this flip flop is going to enable, it is going to toggle to the next state. Okay. That means if initially it was 0, then it will move to 0 to 1 when it will receive 1 here. Okay. And then for this state, that means the A2 was 0, A1, A0 were 1. Okay. So when both A0 and A1 are 1, then you will see that this A0 1 means this output is going to be 1. This point is going to be at 1 level. Okay. A1 is again 1, so this point is going to at 1 level. So output for this AND gate is 1. And in that case, both J and K inputs will receive 1 as a input. Okay. And hence this flip flop will toggle. It will complement its state. Okay. And this condition is actually satisfied. Okay. And you will see that the sequences will be 000, 001, 010, 011 for this given synchronous counter. Okay. And you can also draw the timing diagram. You will get the same timing diagram as we got in the previous case. Okay. Is it clear?